Hello, this is Barb Vancherry, movie editor of the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette. For the first time since the 16th Academy Awards, there are 10 Best Picture nominees. The last time this happened, Casablanca emerged from the field of 10 to win the Best Picture in March of 1944. So that tells you how long ago this was. This year, the question was, what would join a lot of the front runners, such as Avatar and The Hurt Locker and Precious, on this list of 10? And here's what turned up in the nominations. An education. This coming-of-age story is set in 1961 England and stars Carey Mulligan as a 16-year-old who falls for a charming older man, played by Peter Sarsgaard. It turns out that her character, Jenny, may be a standout student, but when it comes to love and life, she has much to learn. A serious man. Academy Award winners Joel and Ethan Coen draw on their roots growing up in 1960s Minnesota in this darkly humorous story about one man's quest to become a serious man. Michael Stuhlbarg, known mostly for his theatrical performances until now, plays a physics professor whose life is under siege. His wife announces she's fallen in love with a pompous acquaintance. His unemployed brother shows no signs of vacating their couch. He has two children, including a son more interested in F Troop and smoking pot than preparing for his bar mitzvah, and a neighbor torments him by sunbathing nude. Amidst all of this, the film explores questions of faith, family responsibility, delinquent behavior, and mortality. Avatar's nomination comes on the heels of the announcement that it has just made more than $2 billion. B as in blue, the color of the movie's distinctive characters, created by James Cameron. More people have seen this nominee in 3D than any other movie in this Oscar season or any other, and that helps to account for the amount of money that it's made around the world. But there are also some slavish fans who call themselves Avatars, and they would say that it's beyond just the 3D, the IMAX. They're totally taken by this universe that Cameron has created. Many years ago, Cameron proclaimed himself King of the World the year he swept the Oscars with Titanic. Now he has another chance to dominate the Academy Awards. Inglourious Basterds is Quentin Tarantino's revenge fantasy, a fairy tale that opens with the telltale phrase, "Once upon a time," in Nazi-occupied France. Although it counts Brad Pitt among its ensemble, it's an Austrian-born actor named Christoph Waltz who steals the show and every supporting actor award in sight so far as a Nazi colonel. Pitt plays an American lieutenant named Aldo Rain, who assembles a band of brothers who promise to be cruel to the Germans, and they are. During the 152-minute movie, you're never quite sure who will live, who will die, and who will survive with the mark of Cain, in this case, a swastika carved in the forehead for all the world to see. District 9. People sometimes confuse prawns with shrimp. No one, however, confuses prawns with people. Prawn is the pejorative term for aliens who came to Earth two decades ago. Their motionless mothership has hovered over Johannesburg, South Africa, as the intergalactic refugees were shunted into tent cities, which turned into permanent slums in a place like Soweto. Tension between humans and aliens runs high in District 9, a thinking person sci-fi film, but with plenty of missiles, gunplay, and gross-out moments, including the transformation of a man's hand into a blackened claw, for starters, to satisfy action addicts and apparently Oscar voters. Precious. Gabourey Sidibe is the accidental movie star. She nearly skipped the casting call so she could attend college class, but fate deposited her near the doorstep of the emissaries for director Lee Daniels, and they knew they had found their Clarice Precious Jones after looking at 500 young women. She plays an overweight, virtually illiterate, and pregnant for the second time teenage girl. And even executive producer Oprah Winfrey has said that it is so raw that it will suck the air out of the room at the end of the film. But she added, and that's a very good thing. The Blind Side. Based on the Michael Lewis book of the same name, The Blind Side tells the story of Michael Orr, a virtually homeless teen from the Hurt Village projects of Memphis. His father is long gone and his mother a crack addict. A family friend helps him to win admission to a private school, but it's Lee Ann Tui, played by Sandra Bullock, who spots him wandering around in November in just a t-shirt and shorts. She invites him to stay at the spacious home she shares with her husband, their teenage daughter, and young son. He soon becomes part of their family. in a story that tells us the true meaning of generosity and what it can mean when someone takes an interest, or is now a rookie tackle with the Baltimore Ravens. The Hurt Locker. Set in 2004 Baghdad, this is the first Iraq war movie to get it right. It's a dusty boots-on-the-ground view of life with army techs faced with improvised explosive devices that can be anywhere, from wires poking up from a trash bag to, sadly, a corpse. Catherine Bigelow, who just won the Directors Guild of America Award, leads actors Jeremy Renner, Anthony Mackie, and Brian Garrity in a powerful story told largely on foreign soil. We get a little look at a bomb tech who's back stateside, and he misses his daily dance with death. Up. With this movie, Pixar went 10 for 10, and now it's one of the big 10. Up is a comedy fantasy about a 78-year-old balloon salesman and woodworker named Carl Fredrickson, the voice of Ed Asner, who rigs thousands of balloons to his house and flies off to South America. He belatedly realizes that an 8-year-old boy named Russell has accidentally come along for the rollicking ride. It manages to remind us about the adventures that happen every day, about the importance of small moments that bind and bond us, and about the makeshift families we can forge. And it also had children and adults howling with delight at talking dogs, a 13-foot-tall bird, and a chocoholic named Kevin. Up in the air. George Clooney is certainly the most famous and valuable face of this movie, but credit for its success also goes to the real jobless people seen in Cameo. They're mixed into the smart, funny, thought-provoking look at a man who travels lightly through life, both literally and figuratively, as he helps companies fire people. Bliss for him is spending 322 days a year on the road, in airports, rental cars, and hotels that look exactly alike no matter the city. The excellent supporting cast also includes Anna Kendrick, Vera Farmiga, and Jason Bateman, but best of all, it takes the screenplay road less traveled.